Hello, my name is Ekaterina, and in today's video, we will discuss built-in property wrappers. Previously, I was explaining how they function. We also learned how to create a customized property wrappers. Now, let's talk about those wrappers that Swift has already offered to us. Before we start, make sure you subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, and let's go. Swift comes with about 17 built-in property wrappers. Let's start with app storage. It is created for reading values from user defaults. User defaults is a property list file. When you write data to user defaults, it automatically gets loaded to your app. So you can easily read the data from there, but it's recommended not to store a lot of data in it. But what if we want to change data stored in another view? How do we access this property? We can use a wrapper called binding. The binding provides reference access for the value type. Part wrapper is the environment. The environment property wrapper lets us read data from the system. For example, you can get color scheme, accessibility options, trade collections, and your own keys if you want. So next, we come to the environment object. If you create a user that will be shared across many parts, you should use environment object property. Now we come to fetch request property. To fetch the core data request, or to embed the data directly in Swift UI without extra logic, we use a fetch request wrapper. The next property wrapper we consider is focused binding. Focused binding wrapper is needed to watch the values in the key window. Now we will consider focused value wrapper. It is simply a version of a focused binding. It doesn't unwrap the bound value and it does not own the data. Next wrapper is gesture state. It helps us to track the state of gestures that we use. The wrapper stores the value associated with gestures in progress. It is similar to state property, but gesture state automatically sets a property back to the initial value at the end of a gesture. Now we come to a namespace property wrapper. It creates an animation namespace to allow matched geometry effects, which will be shared by other views. It owns its data. Next, wrapper is NS Application Delegate Adapter. It is used to create a register class as the app delegate for the macOS app. It owns its data. Next, wrapper is Observed Object. It is used for the purpose of views being able to watch the external object and be notified when something has changed there. Here is one of the most used property wrappers, Published. It allows to create observable objects that automatically announced when the changes occur. Next property wrappers is scaled metric. To save unique data for each of your screens, you can use Swift UI's scene storage property wrappers. For example, if you have a text editor and want to store what the user is typing, one of the most crucial wrappers is state. It allows to modify values inside a struct, which would normally be not allowed because structs are value types. When we put state before a property, we effectively move its storage out from struct to the shared storage managed by Swift UI. State object property wrapper is used to create a reference type inside the view. You should use state object only once per object. The next wrapper is UI application delegate adapter. It is used to create and register class as an app delegate. This was the second part of the video about property wrappers. Now we know what wrapper solutions Swift offered to us. I hope that this topic was useful for you. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and see you in the next videos. Bye!